Dr. Swati, again, working as an Ayurveda consultant in Birla Ayurveda. Today I am going to discuss about the treatment Virechana. Virechana is one of the Panchakarma therapy in Ayurveda. Virechana means usually we are suggesting a Pitta predominant condition or a combination with the Pitta. And this is one of the complete detoxification treatment in Ayurveda, or we can say it is a purgative therapy. And we will start with the Devanabhajana procedure. This is to improve the digestive power of the patient. And after that we will start the Snehapana after analyzing the prakriti of the patient as well as the prakriti of the disease. It may be Mahatitangartam, Gugrutiktuangartam, Mahakalyanangartam. It may vary according to patients. And the dosage of the ghee also will vary day by day. That is, we'll gradually increase the dosage of the ghee. And during the Snehapanam days, the one should be in a strict diet, that is advised by the doctor. Snehapanam is mainly to loose and mobilize the toxins from all the part of the body, and it will be accumulated in the stomach after Snehapanam. After analyzing the Samyakshuddhi lakshana, that is, one will feel like oily smell or oily texture in the stool, urine, skin, etc. And after analyzing this, we will stop the Snehapana procedure and we will go for the external ovulation, that is massage, abhyangam and steam. On the next time, 6th and 7th day, or that is according to Snehapana days, on the 6th or 7th day, we will give the external ovulation and the massage. And also on the 7th day morning, empty stomach, we use to give the purgation medicine, that after analyzing the patient's condition. And purgation will continue until the complete detoxification of the accumulated toxins from the gastrointestinal tract. And that the number of vekas or the number of motions will vary according to the patient's health condition. And after the Virechana, the patient should be advised to take complete rest. And also after analyzing the last day of the Virechana, like how many times the motions are there, according to that we will suggest the diet and the diet chart of the patient. And it is mainly indicated in the Pitta predominant conditions like diarrhea, diabetes, jaundice, skin disorders like psoriasis, eczema, arthritis, inflammatory condition, etc. It is highly contraindicated in conditions like diarrhea, highly emaciated patients, rectal bleeding like pile cyst, laingiki, etc. For more details, you can see our website www.birla.